Good evening, everyone. My name is Dr. Saurabh Roy. I welcome you all in the lecture of microwave engineering. So in the last lecture, we discussed about the Rydley-Watkins helium-helium theory. And also we discussed about the transverse electron devices, how it is different from the transistor, why transistor is not used for high frequencies. So those things we discussed. And some gallium arsenide, N-type gallium arsenide discovered by Gunn, and what are the different effects of Gunn, also we will discuss in the last lecture. Now in this lecture, we will discuss about another two bellum model theory, that is for negative resistance, achieving of negative resistance in a bulk semiconductor devices, how you can achieve that two bellum model theory. And another things we will discuss, that modes of operation, what are the different modes are there for operating that gallium arsenide or negative resistance based active devices. So those things we will discuss today. So first started from the two bellum model theory. So a few years before Gunn effect, so Cromer, one another scientist, proposed a negative mass microwave amplifier in 1958 and 1959. Okay, so that is before the Gunn effect. So Cromer proposed a negative mass microwave amplifier in 1958 and 59. So according to the energy band theory of n-type gallium arsenide, a high mobility of lower belly is separated by an energy of 0.36 electron volt from a low mobility upper belly. Okay, so you may be confused why this energy. So that is similar to the EDC, energy band diagram in electronics devices circuit. Whenever we will see the semiconductor, we divide in three: balance band, conduction band, and forbidden gap. So similar things, but here we are considering the n-type gallium arsenide, okay? Because in negative resistant devices, 3-5 semiconductor devices are used to generate the negative resistant properties, which devices are called active devices, okay? So here, according to the two value model theory for n-type gallium arsenide, here the conduction band is divided into two different bellies. One is lower belly, another one is upper belly, and the band gap of that two bellies 0.36 electron volt. Okay, so first we'll see that is the n-type gallium arsenide. So earlier we told you that EDC we discussed that different band. So similar here. So one is that is a balance band. For this one is for n-type gallium arsenide. So that is the conduction band and then is the forbidden band. Okay, so energy gap between the balance band and conduction band, that gap is 1.43 electron volt. So that much energy is required to transfer the electron from balance band to conduction band. But n-type gallium arsenide, that conduction band is separated by using two belly. Okay, we can separate that conduction band two belly region. One is the called lower belly region, another one is the called upper belly region. So those are the two belly. Okay, so the gap between two energy, that is the 0.36 electron volt. So that gap we can calculate the bottom of the lower belly and this bottom of the upper belly. Okay, so these two bottom of the lower belly and bottom of that, so that the gap is 0.036 electron volt. Okay, so another difference is in the lower belly and upper belly, the mass of the electron or effective mass of the electron is less in the lower belly region, but effective mass of the electron, that is 1.2 in the upper belly region. And another thing is there, in the lower belly region, the mobility of the electron, so the mobility value of the electron near about 8000 centimeter square per volt second, but in upper belly region, the mobility of the electron value is very low, that is 180 centimeters per second. So those are the three things. One is mobility, another one is that gap, and another thing. So those are the special properties of n-type gallium arsenide, or we can consider for 3-5 that compound semiconductor devices. Here conduction band, we can divide it into two categories, lower belly and upper belly. And based on things that two belly model theory is developed. So how using two belly model theory, the negative resistance property of the devices is generated. Okay, so we discuss simply here. Now we'll go in the details. Now the electron density, so in the lower belly and upper belly, so that is only in conduction band, we categorize into two belly, lower and upper belly, remains same under an equilibrium condition. Okay, so in the lower belly and upper belly region, the conduction of the density of the electron is same, in the remains same under an equilibrium condition. Okay, now coming to the, when the applied electric field is lower than the electric field of the lower belly, no electron will transfer to the upper belly. So if applied electric field is lower than the electric field of lower belly, then no electron will transfer from lower belly to the upper belly. Now when the applied electric field is higher than that of lower belly but lower than that of upper belly, the electrons will begin to transfer. Okay, so here in conduction band, some of the electron will transfer from lower belly to the upper belly region, and that band gap is 0.036 electron volt. Now coming to the when the applied electric field is higher than that of upper belly, all electrons will transfer to the upper belly. So there are three conditions are there. One is when the applied electric field is lower than the electric field of the lower belly, when is lower than the electric field of lower belly but upper less than the electric field belly of the upper belly, and last one is the electric field is higher than the upper belly. So those things we can see by using this specific diagram in different region. So first we will, in the first diagram we'll see that electric field is lower than the value of electric field of the lower belly region. So if E is less than E of L, then those are significant the electrons. So if we'll that see those dots, so those are means some electrons. So no electrons will transform from the, this is the lower belly to the upper belly. Okay, so no electron will transfer in this particular condition. Okay, but if the electric field is upper than the lower belly electric field but lower than the upper value of the electric field, some of the electron will transfer to the upper belly region. Okay, so here some of the electron will, what electrons transfer is beginning or begin to transfer the electron from lower belly to the upper belly region. Now coming to the next point, if electric field is greater than the upper belly region, then all the electron from lower belly to the upper belly, the things will transfer. So there are three criteria is there, one is less than, one is greater than, and one is in between them. So less than, no electron will transfer, greater than, all electron will transfer, and in between some of the electron will begin to transfer from lower belly to the upper belly. Okay, so all those two belly are in the conduction band region. Now coming to the next point, on the basis of RWH theory, Ridley, Watkins, Hilsum theory, already we discussed in the last lecture, the band structure of a semiconductor must satisfy the three criteria in order to exhibit negative resistance. So according to the RWH theory, the band structure of a semiconductor must satisfy three criteria to exhibit negative resistance property. So first see what is the first criteria. The separation energy gap between the bottom of the lower and the bottom of the upper belly must be several times greater than the thermal energy, that is about 0.026 electron volt at room temperature. This means del E must be greater than KT or del E must be greater than 0.026 electron volt. So it means that already we told in the n-type gallium arsenide type devices, the lower belly and upper belly two valleys are there in the conduction band. So here it means that if this is considered the lower belly and this one is considered the higher belly, then according to RWH theory, the band gap, so that band gap must be several times that band gap, this will consider this like that. So band gap, this energy band gap, that is if we'll consider del of E. Okay, so we will calculate that the lower belly of lower and the bottom of the upper belly. Okay, so we'll consider, so that del E must be greater than, several times higher than that KT at room temperature. Okay, or we can say that del E equal to 0.026 electron volt. So it must be greater than this particular belly, then only the negative resistance behavior of a particular devices, the 3-5 semiconductor devices, will achieve. Okay, so that is the first condition or first criteria. Now coming to the second point. Second point is also very crucial. So the separation energy between the bellies must be smaller than the gap energy between the conduction and balancement. So first we consider that it should be greater than this value, but this value must be smaller than the energy gap between the conduction band and balancement. So why it is smaller than the energy band of conduction and balancement energy gap? Because if it is greater than delta, otherwise the semiconductor will break down. Okay, and all the electrons will transfer from the balance band to the conduction band. It act like a conductor devices. Okay, so it must be del E must be less than the Eg. Del E, so first criteria is del E must be greater than kT or del E must be several times higher than that 0.026 electron volt. And second criteria is del E must be lesser than the Eg. So where Eg refers the gap between conduction band and balance band. So earlier we mentioned that the in the two valley theorem, that is the Eg. So here we are considering three band. Okay, so this one is the balance band, this one is the conduction band. Okay, so in between conduction and there is a that energy gap is there, so that is called Eg. Okay, if we'll consider this one is the conduction band, then that band is called forbidden band gap. Okay, so this Eg, their delta must be less than Eg. Okay, so that is the point. So first point is the delta must be greater than kT. Second point is delta must be less than Eg. Now come to the third. So according to that theory, RWH theory, the electrons in the lower belly must be high mobility. So conduction band we divide into two categories. One is the lower belly, one is the upper belly. So electrons in the lower belly must be high mobility, small effective mass and low density state. Okay, so this is the condition for the lower belly electron. Now coming to the higher, whereas those in the upper belly region must have low mobility, large effective mass and a high density of state. Okay, so these are the three conditions. So first condition we'll see that del E, that 0. That is the typical n-type gallium arsenide devices band structure. So that del E must be greater than the this room temperature. So first criteria is del E must be greater than the 0.026 electron volt. Okay. So del E must be greater than 0.026 electron volt several times. So it is satisfied for n-type gallium arsenide. Second, according to second theory, del E must be less than Eg. Okay. So here del E is 0.36 electron volt. So it here Eg is 1.43 electron volt. So del E is less than Eg. And third is the lower belly must be high mobility. Yeah, it's high mobility, low effective mass and low density state. Okay, and similarly upper belly, low mobility, high effective mass and high density state. So those are the three criteria which is satisfied by n-type gallium arsenide. If the first one is the del E must be greater than kT or 0.026 electron volt, second one del E must be less than Eg, and third one is the lower belly to the upper belly, whatever the electron mobility, mass mobility should be high, mass should be less, another one is low density state. This one is the mobility must be low, mass is effective mass is high and low mobility and having low mobility. Okay, or low density, high density state. Okay, so those are the criteria. So according to RWH theory, that n-type gallium arsenide or 3-5 semiconductor devices, those type devices which show negative resistance property covered all those three properties. Okay, now coming to the next. So there are two most useful semiconductor we are using. One is, we know that is silicon, another one we are using that is called germanium, but they are not, do not meet all those criteria. Okay, so the devices, the some compound semiconductors such as gallium arsenide, indium phosphide, cadmium telluride satisfy those criteria. Okay, shows a possible current versus field characteristics of a two-valley semiconductor. So that is the possible current versus electric field versus drift velocity of a two-valley semiconductor device. So here we will see the drift velocity is increases, so that is the threshold limit. After that, so here the velocity of drift velocity is increases mu equal to BD by E, so we increases linearly, but after that this threshold limit the things is decreases. If electric field is decreases, drift velocity is decreases. Okay, so that is the negative resistance property is achieved in that particular region. So that can be achieved by those devices or those indium phosphide, cadmium telluride. So those are the semiconductor which satisfy those criteria. And our earlier semiconductor like silicon and germanium do not meet all those criteria. Okay. So two valley theory, the drip velocity versus electric field diagram will be like that. Okay. Now coming to the modes of operation. So here we'll see, since Gahn first announced his observation of microwave oscillation in the n-type gallium arsenide or n-type indium phosphide diode in 1963. So here he discussed the various modes have been developed depending on material, which type of material we are using, material parameters, as well as its operating condition, which condition we are operating. So depends on the material parameters and operating condition, the modes have different. So as noted, the formation of a strong space charge instability depends on the condition that enough charge is available in the crystal, and the specimen must be long enough so that the necessary amount of space charge can be built up within the transit time of the electron. So those are some criteria for which mode of operation will be occur in gallium arsenide diode or indium phosphide diode, which observed in Gahn in 1963. So based on his observation, this requirement set of criteria, he discovered or he observed that the things is working in four different modes. So one is Gahn oscillation mode, second one is Tabel amplification mode, third one is LSA oscillation mode, and fourth one is bias circuit oscillation mode. So first here we'll see that is the Gahn mode is there, Gahn oscillation mode is there. Second one is comes to the Gahn oscillation mode is there. Second one is comes to stable amplification of mode, and that is the LS mode. Okay. So this bias circuit oscillation mode is not seen in this diagram or in this figure, because this mode is working in lower frequency region. So we'll discuss one by one mode. So first started from Gahn oscillation mode. So this mode is defined in the region where the product of frequency multiplied by length is about 10 to the power 7 centimeter per second, and the product of doping multiplied by length is greater than the 10 to the power 12 centimeters. So those are the that particular things where in the vertical axis we multiplied frequency multiplied by length, it should be this value and this particular range. So this range is Gahn oscillation mode will work. Now in this region the device is unstable because of the cyclic formation of either the accumulation layer or the high field domain. In a circuit with relatively low impedance, the device operated in the high field domain mode, and the frequency of oscillation is near the intrinsic frequency. When the device is operated in relative high Q cavity and coupled properly to the load, the domain is quenched or delayed before nucleating. So those are the operation of the or principle of the Gahn oscillation mode. So in this case, the oscillation frequency is almost entirely determined by the resonant frequency of the cavity and has a value of several times the intrinsic frequency. Okay, so the mode is defined in this particular ranges. We'll see in that, and high Q cavity and coupled properly to the load, the domain is quenched or delayed before nucleating. Okay, so next mode is stable amplification mode. So this mode is defined in the region where the product of frequency times length is about 10 to the power 7 centimeters per second, and product of doping times length is between 10 to the power 11 and 10 to the power 12 per centimeter square. Okay, so that mode is called stable amplification mode. Now coming to the another mode, that is the LSA oscillation mode. So it is a limited space charge accumulation mode. That LSA is limited space charge accumulation oscillation mode. So this mode is defined in the region of product of frequency which is above 10 to the power 7 centimeter per second and the quotient of duping divided by frequency length in between 2 into 10 to the power 4 to 2 into 10 to the power 5. So that is the two things. One is stable amplification. It started about 10 to the power 7, but it is length is above 10 to the power 7. So that is the difference of stable and LSA oscillation. Now coming to the next. So that is the bias circuit oscillation mode. So that is the last mode. So this mode occurs only when there is either GaN or LSA oscillation and it is usually at the region where the product of frequency times length is too small to appear in the figure. When a bulk diode is biased to threshold, the average current suddenly drops as GaN oscillation begins. The drop in the current or the threshold lead to oscillation in the bias circuit is typically 1 kilowatts to 100 megahertz. So this bias circuit oscillation mode basically frequency length is too small. So that's why it is not shown in the figure, or bias circuit oscillation mode. So it's not shown in the figure. So if we'll see that GaN oscillation mode, so here this one is the duping into length. So these things will come when this duping length is 10 to the power 8 to, so this particular domain, and above then 10 to the power 12. So here we'll see the stable amplification mode will come when it is 10 to the power 7 and just 10 to the power 7, and this particular less than 10 to the power 11 to 10 to the power 12. So this is the stable amplification mode. Similarly, that LSA, so that will come above that 10 to the power 7. This one is the above line, above that 10 to the power 7, but it will come in this particular where duping quotient of, this is the quotient of duping divided by frequency in between 2 into 10 to the power, that is 2 into 10 to the power 4, and this line is belongs to 2 into 10 to the power 5. So that is the LSA amplification or oscillation mode, and this one is the stable amplification mode. So those are the terms of, and this one is the quenched domain GaN. So delayed domain also we discuss in GaN oscillation mode. So those are the three particular mode, and another mode is the bias circuitry mode. So this is not coming in the figure. So in the y-axis we'll see it is frequency into length, that is centimeter per second, and in the x-axis we'll see that is duping into length. So those are the different modes which is observed in the GaN oscillation or GaN n-type gallium arsenide diode. So four basically which is observed by GaN. Okay, so next lecture we'll talk about the other type of devices, avalanche transient time devices, impact diode, then as well as we'll discuss the other types of negative resistance active devices. Thank you everyone.